Okay, John Jay says, Nick and Spencer both have terrible optics. Who knows who are feds and who aren't? I don't know and I don't care about feds' question. And he says, P.S. keep JF commercially viable on YouTube. And JP says, surely you can grant that Nick Fuentes has superior optics to Richard Spencer. Objectively, I'll be honest, knowing all of the little clips that I can pull from Nick Fuentes, if I go on left-wing forums, I will be very honest with you guys. I don't know at the end if you could stack a greater case against Nick Fuentes than against Richard. To be honest, it's not so much that I don't know about Nick, it's that I'm not sure about Richard Spencer. Because I've seen mostly mainstream appearances of Richard Spencer. I don't know if you really dig in his past how much you can find. There is, of course, the recent audio, the hidden audio. But in the end, once they're done doing their job against Nick, you will have what? You will have Holocaust denial. You will have racist comments in private from the perspective of a leftist. Of course, I'm not saying Nick was wrong or anything, but the fact is he has been taken in private speaking in disgusting fashion against race mixing. So that is a fact that the leftists will bring. He has been making jokes around genocide. He has been endorsing fascism explicitly and the martel brand of fascism. He has been saying that if there was a Franco flag being raised, he would join. So he would join fascism. I'm gonna be very honest. In terms of computing optics, it's not something I'm good at because it's not something I care about. But I think you guys are extremely deluded to be thinking that it will be so different this time. No, you're gonna face the exact same thing. Just know that every event that is happening in this Groypers Rise, although exciting and everything, and although I will cover them and I will be an ally to the extent that I agree and want that, but just know that this has all happened before. Christian rising for a kind of fascistic Christian government within a conservative movement in Western civilization, it all happened before. It happens 20 years ago. In fact, the rise of much of identitarianism of the kind that Richard Spencer has been pushing has happened in response to such movements already existing in the past.
Yeah, all right. I mean, when I think back to, you know, the alt-right and 2016, 17, I think part of the problem, part of the failure was that when they tried to go, you know, boots on the ground and turn into a political movement, I think the alt-right and what Richard Spencer had always advocated was much more meta-political, and it was trying to, you know, completely get outside the paradigm of left-right. But I think when you turn it into something that's explicitly political, you inevitably fall into that. And so, you know, I think the alt-right was kind of like, you know, if this America First is a bit like Otpor, the organization I mentioned in Serbia, it's kind of a single issue battering ram against the system. Whereas the alt-right is kind of more of a Occupy Wall Street thing, and that it was meta-political. There wasn't a common goal, but there was a common sentiment. But it's very hard to turn a common sentiment into real life action when there's so much dissent in terms of political approaches.
All right. And No Guilt, Only Pride on the regular chat says, JF, come on now. They're young, but at least they're right wing. Cut them some slack. But Nick needs to stop disavowing people. Oh, yeah. I mean, that's all I'm saying, really. I'm not saying their goal is not just and fair and that I'm not joining them. I am with them. But if someone I love or someone I respect comes to me with false statements and false analysis of the situation, and they have a false conception of themselves and they are being self-deceptive, I'm gonna call it out. It's tough love. It's what it is, really. So today, Ben Shapiro